So two really big issues, the stress book now, that is BB and below, ballooning to 30,000 crore, and therefore the requirement of more capital. Ravikant Bhat of IndiaNivesh with us. Good morning, Ravi. What's your reading first of the stress book? How much does it go to? Does it go from 5.1, the GNPA, to double that, to 8%?
So Lata, if we see what happened in case of ICICI Bank and Axis Bank particularly, if you recall, Axis Bank had announced a watch list of 23,000 crore and almost all of it became NPA, and then the focus shifted to BB and below. I think at this point of time, it's pretty clear with the kind of delinquency that we have already seen in first quarter, we would be inclined to actually view most of the watch list, remainder watch list, as being under stress. The 29,000 odd crore of the total BB and below book is substantially large. But if I were to start, if I were to make a start, I would at least look at this watch list with suspicion of
8,000 crore or 7,500.
7,500, that's right. So 2,500 already got liquidated. So we have got 75 odd billion of watch list remaining. I think one should look at it, as being more or less NPA. I know that the opinions vary on the street, but given the past experiences with other large banks, I would be inclined to believe most of this could slip.
Okay. In fact, the below investment grade book has now increased to 9.4% from 7.1% of corporate exposure. Ravikant, you expect that to worsen as well? And how much of this you think has been factored into the stock? I mean, it's already lost 70% of its value in less than 4 months.
So I think this was coming, and the fourth quarter loss was obviously something kind of a minor shocker, and after the watch list was announced post fourth quarter results, it did get factored into the price, but I think some bit of that was still remaining, and we are going to see the reaction to that today. I would just point out that a third of the double band below book is basically the watch list. I think there's some more bit of reaction remaining on the stock.
Okay. How much capital do you think they will need?
Okay, so I mean, if I were to look at the peers and the way usually the private banks have maintained capitalization levels, typically 11.5% is the floor for tier one. But we are talking of desperate times, and I'm looking at something. So the board has got an enabling resolution for the bank has got a resolution for about $1 billion. I think that should pump up their CET1 by about upwards of 150-170 basis points, and that should be a decent alibi for them in the near term to at least get the business going, because from what we understand, if you look at the other pieces of business, especially the retail and even the branch banking side, they have actually added employees during the quarter, so that seems to be doing fine. With the capital coming in, I think at least a mid-teen kind of loan growth would ensure that you keep the operating profit line ticking.
Okay, so that will also mean dilution book as well. Yeah. As EPS. So what price?
Our target price. So yes. we are still sellers. So we turned sellers post for Q4 results, and we are still sellers with a target price of about 80.
Okay. Yeah. All right. That's not very close. Actually, 10% lower would bring it there. 88 was the low, I think, the stock saw. Okay, Ravikant, thank you very much. You want to ask something?
No, I was just looking at the chart. I mean, it's already fallen from 280, which less than 4 months ago, it was at about almost 280. It's lost 70% of its value, and people are expecting further lower levels.